So it looks like we already have Kristen Ingram joining us. Hello, Kristen. How's it going? And I want to welcome everyone to Tuesday Tidbits. Hi. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Jeffrey W. Ingram. I am the founder and co-host of the World Builders Anvil podcast. And on every Tuesday at 1 o'clock Eric Standard Time, I like to go live to do a short little additional episode. Excuse me. And for these episodes, which are brought to you by my other free project, howtoworldbuild.com, I like to just take a moment to review the last week's episode was on frameworks and why I love them so much. And if you have not yet listened to episode 262, make sure to go into the description of this video, and there will be a link to it right there. You can go check it out. But it's why I've been working on a framework for world building. And the thing I realized after I got through with it is I really missed the core reason I love frameworks. And to be honest, it goes back to my childhood. In my childhood, I was obsessed with cultures, and I blame my parents for this. They got a National Geographic magazine that had really cool maps, and I loved sort of reading about the cultures in National Geographic, and I'd go over the maps, and it occurred to me, I don't know what age, this is before role-playing games even came to me, so I must have been like around eight, but I wonder why, you know, they talked about like a city here or a village here in the article, but they never talked about, you know, this city here and that city here. So in my brain, I started making up what this name on the map equal, you know, in game theory, I believe they call it addition through subtraction. So when you take things out, you know, you give people a little taste of it, but you don't say what it is. It gets people's imaginations going, and they will naturally fill in the details. And I was doing this at a very young age, just looking at maps and reading National Geographic. And so it kind of, you know, led me to this idea of, you know, also through my education of like modern geography is you look at a place like the Balkans, and the Balkans are full of several different ethnicities. But then you look at like England, and everyone there calls themselves English, or they at least do in the modern day. But if you go further back, you know, there were Anglo-Saxons, there were Norsemen, there were Britons, there were all types of people who lived in Britain. But if you come to today, they all end up calling themselves English. Why does that happen? But in the Balkans, you still have, you know, a mosaic of ethnicities that dot it, you know, really Balkanize it, you might say. And so these things always really obsessed me. And this is kind of one of the reasons I really love like the idea of world building through frameworks. And it's because of the flexibility it gives me. It gives me a couple different ways to think about my world building is, you know, when I create a new world, it's usually for a project, for something I want to write, or for, you know, a game I want to play. That's the foundation of the world for me. It's a story. But in that though, I can drive a lot of entertainment from world building itself by choosing the way I world build. And so I can actually sit there and go, this is what my world looked like in the Stone Age. And then it changed through wargaming. It changed and looked this way in the Bronze Age. What happened? What caused those changes? Those are all potential story threads. Those are all potential adventures if you're doing a game. And it helps naturally build up rivalries between nations, or some nations disappear to leave those ancient ruins for the people who are in the world of the future, you know, that you're actually playing. And, you know, they look back at the past, they find these ruins. Who made those ruins? Why were they there? You know, let's go into this ruin and explore it, and we'll call it a dungeon. And all of these things really just excite me. But the flexibility of creating the framework, you know, allows me to sit there and go, okay, let me look at my world at a few different time periods and just wargame out What I want to happen is kind of like playing a video game where all of the rules are just in my head. And I can just sit there on, you know, I like using the maps for this, and I can draw out, okay, this part was this, and then they invaded over here, or they were thrown into a revolution. And it just allows me to start asking those questions, which if you gone to howtoworldbuild.com, I say it's the why, when, where, how types of questions that make world building good. And then you just keep asking why. And, you know, wargaming with maps on a world really gives you a lot of idea of why there are frictions that feel natural to people. You know, it makes sense for two bordering countries to have enmity, but then how come Netherlands and Belgium don't have that type of enmity, right? And maybe they did at some point, but today it's different. And, you know, these are all interesting questions, but the strength of a framework is it gives you the flexibility to tackle it in the tidbits that you want to in a way that's interesting to you, so you can derive so much additional joy out of the act of world building. So I'm going to throw a link in here right now. If you're interested in the idea of frameworks, go to howtoworldbuild.com/soon. And I'm actually, I've put up a landing page there where I'm going to ask people some questions or whatever as I'm moving along. And I'm going to, you know, here coming up soon, probably in a, it's just a little bit over a week away. I'll be announcing more about my framework and, how other people can access it. So go to howtoworldbuild.com/soon, and it should take you there, or just click on the link in the comments right here. Tell me, what's your big obsessions? What are the things that you really like about world building? Go ahead and throw those in the comments below too. I'm just wondering. I know I have lots of world builders out there and lots of, you know, different ways of achieving things. I'm just always interesting for you to know. So, hope you're all having a wonderful day, and I will talk to you later.